TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Lipakshi Khurana. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Monday, the 13th of January. Indian Foreign Minister meets SCO Secretary General in New Delhi. Reduction of violence not practical, says Afghan Presidential Palace. A Nepal Parliament session halted for third time amid indecision to choose Speaker. And now for all the details, Indian Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar met Shanghai Cooperation Organization or SCO Secretary General Vladimir Norov in New Delhi on Monday. Both the leaders reviewed progress as India prepares to chair the Council of SCO Head of Government this year.
Indian Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar on Monday met Shanghai Cooperation Organization Secretary General Vladimir Norov in capital New Delhi. Both the leaders reviewed the progress in cooperation as India prepares to take up the responsibility of chairing the Council of SCO Heads of Government this year. Jaishankar in a tweet said that he appreciated the SCO's efforts to promote tourism among member states. He said the eighth wonder of SCO, which includes the Statue of Unity, will surely serve as an inspiration. The Shanghai Cooperation Organization, or SCO, is a China-led eight-member economic and security bloc. India and Pakistan officially joined SCO as full members at a summit in Astana in 2017. Norov arrived for a four-day India visit on Sunday to attend the Raisina Dialogue, an annual multilateral conference which will begin on Tuesday.
In news from Pakistan, Mutahida Qawmi Movement Pakistan convener Khalid Maqbool Siddiqui on Sunday announced that he was resigning from his post as Information Technology Minister. He, however, clarified his party will continue to support Prime Minister Imran Khan's ruling Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf.
Mutahida Qawmi Movement Pakistan or MQMP convener Khalid Maqbool Siddiqui on Sunday announced that he was resigning from his post as Minister for Information Technology. Addressing a press conference in Pakistan's Karachi city, Siddiqui said that he was quitting over unfulfilled promises. He said that after 16 to 17 months, not even one point regarding the conditions in Sindh had seen progress. He, however, clarified that MQMP supported the ruling Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf or PTI in forming the government, and the party was not ending its cooperation with the government. Siddiqui's announcement came a month after Pakistan People's Party chairperson Bilawal Bhutto Zardari offered MQMP ministries in Sindh in exchange for the party breaking off its alliance in the centre with the ruling PTI. Following Bilawal's offer, MQMP had not outright rejected the offer, but described it as a non-serious attempt. Siddiqui clarified on Sunday his resignation has no connection to that.
News just in, a Pakistani court on Monday annulled the death sentence handed to former military ruler Parvez Musharraf, ruling that the special court, which had found him guilty of treason, was unconstitutional. Former President Musharraf was sentenced to death in December last year on treason charges stemming from his imposition of a state of emergency in 2007. And moving on, persons with disabilities recently staged a protest to demand the funds allocated for their welfare by the provincial government in Gilgit-Baltistan. They said the Chief Minister had announced a grant of nearly 5 crore rupees, but the bureaucracy has been denying it to them.
Persons with disabilities recently held a protest in Gilgit-Baltistan to demand the package of nearly 5 crore rupees allocated for their welfare by the provincial government in the illegally occupied region. Chairman of Gilgit-Baltistan Disability Development Foundation, Irshad Kazmi, said that the region's chief minister had allocated the grant, after which lists of around 700 beneficiaries was made. He said the bureaucracy has been, however, denying the grant to them. The protesters said it is a violation of their rights and warned they would continue their protest if their issues were not resolved soon.
कोई तकरीबन 700 अपराध की लिस्टें बनी थी जिनमें से कोई 70 अपराध को फर्स्ट फेज में पैसे फराहम कर दिए गए बाकी जो 600 की करीब हमारी लिस्टें हैं उन्हें अभी सोशल वेलफेयर डिपार्टमेंट यह कहता है कि इनको देने के लिए हमें पैसे फराहम नहीं किए गए हैं
तो मैं गुजारिश करूंगा यहां पे चीफ सेक्रेटरी साहब को कि आज हम यहां पे पुरमन एमन रोड पे बैठे हुए हैं 3 हफ्ते के अंदर हमने चार ड्राफ्ट डिमांड साफी हजरात और एजेंसियों को भी हमने दिए हैं अगर इस पे इंप्लीमेंट नहीं होता है तो हम मजबूर होंगे कि हम आपके ऑफिस का घेराव करेंगे अपने बाल बच्चों के साथ
This is not the first time people have to often hit the streets to demand even their basic rights in the region. Gilgit-Baltistan has been under a corrupt administration since its illegal occupation by Pakistan more than 70 years ago.
Afghanistan's government has insisted on a permanent end of war through a ceasefire and said reduction of violence by Taliban has no accurate meaning legally and it is not practical. This comes as Taliban earlier in a statement agreed to reduce violence as part of a pending peace deal with the United States. The group rejected possibilities of a ceasefire.
Spokesperson to the Afghan President Ashraf Ghani, Sadiq Siddiqui, has said a ceasefire is the government's plan for beginning peace negotiations and that reduction of violence is not practical. Siddiqui, in a tweet on Sunday, said by ceasefire, the Afghan government means a ceasefire like the one established in the country 2 years ago during the Eid days. The remarks came days after Taliban in a statement said that discussions are still underway about a reduction of violence and lessened operations, but it rejected possibilities of a temporary ceasefire. The Taliban had agreed for a three-day ceasefire earlier in 2018 with the Afghan government forces, coinciding with Eid, days after a unilateral ceasefire was ordered by the government. It was the Taliban's first ceasefire since the government they ran was toppled by the 2001 United States-led invasion.
In news from Nepal, the failure to achieve a political consensus over electing a new House Speaker has been hitting Nepal's parliamentary session hard. The meeting of the lower house of the parliament was called off for the third time on Sunday as the Speaker's post remains vacant.
Meeting of the lower house of Nepal's parliament has been called off for the third time in the latest winter session as new house speaker has not been elected yet. The parliament secretariat on Sunday announced adjournment of the parliamentary meeting till January 20, citing failure among the ruling Nepal Communist Party to reach consensus on electing a new speaker for the house, local media reports said. Deputy Speaker of Nepal's lower house Shivamaya Tumbahampe was scheduled to chair the meeting on Sunday, but it was cancelled as per the decision of the Deputy Speaker herself. Post of Speaker of Nepal's lower house has remained vacant after Krishna Bahadur Mahara stepped down on October 2nd last year following attempt to rape charges levelled against him. Mahara is presently in police custody for further investigation into the case against him.
More news from Nepal. Nepal observed its Unification Day and paid tribute to late King Prithvi Narayan Shah in capital Kathmandu on Sunday. Hundreds of Nepali people felicitated the statue of the unifier of modern Nepal with garlands on his 298th birth anniversary.
Nepal observed its Unification Day and paid tribute to the late King Prithvi Narayan Shah in the capital Kathmandu on Sunday. Hundreds of people poured onto the roads of Kathmandu and gathered in front of Singha Darbar to pay tribute to the statue of Prithvi Narayan Shah to mark the 298th birth anniversary of the late king. As part of the celebrations, various participants sported traditional attires and performed on traditional music around the statue.
Ma aajako din ma Nepal rashtra ka nirmata aaja bhanda 200 98 वर्ष अगाडि जन्मनु भएका विभिन्न टुक्रा टुक्रामा रहेको यो मुलुकलाई एकीकरण गरेर आज सिंगो एउटा नेपालको जुन पहिचान दिनु भएको छ जुन हामीलाई एउटा नेपाली नागरिकको रूपमा चाहिँ नि हामीलाई उभिने एउटा पहिचान बनाउने एउटा मौका दिनु भएको छ आज म र सम्पूर्ण हामी नेपाली जो हामी नेपाली भन्छौ हामीले उहाँलाई एउटा राष्ट्र निर्माताको रूपमा चाहिँ स्मरण गर्दछौ
Prithvi Narayan Shah, the king of princely state named Gorkha, has unified princely states and created modern Nepal. He is said to have amalgamated ever-fighting states and made them a part of Nepal when the British Empire was making inroads into India.
In news from Bangladesh, tens of thousands of Muslims from across the world attended special prayers in Tongi in Bangladesh to end the first phase of Bishwa Ijtima pilgrimage. The annual event is the second biggest gathering of Muslims after the Hajj.
Tens of thousands of Muslims from Bangladesh and abroad braved cold weather as they gathered at the final prayer of the Bishwa Ijtima annual pilgrimage on Sunday. The annual congregation is the second biggest gathering of Muslims after the Hajj and takes place at the bank of Turag River near the capital Dhaka. The three-day Bishwa Ijtima has been held at the same site since 1966 and is organized by World Tabligh Council, which preaches teachings of Islam and Prophet Muhammad. In order to manage the growing number of devotees coming from across Bangladesh and abroad, the Holy Congregation is being held in two phases since the year 2011.
Boro dhoroner istema hajer pori eta boro sthan ekhane sobai ashe amra muslimanra sob ekotrito hoy ekhane amra hajer pore je boro dua hobe eta ei dua dara amader desher ebong amader shobar upokar hobe.
Overcrowded trains and buses carried scores of worshippers to and from the prayer event in the first phase. The second phase of the pilgrimage, also spanning 3 days, is scheduled to begin on January 17 at the same venue. Bangladesh is home to 169 million people, the majority of whom are Muslims.
Fresh spell of snowfall in India's northern Jammu and Kashmir territory brought joy to residents on Sunday. It, however, affected normal life and flight operations were also disrupted. Jammu and Kashmir, a holiday paradise, especially during the winter, registers large footfall of tourists who flocked to witness snowfall.
Fresh spell of snowfall in Srinagar city of India's northern Jammu and Kashmir territory brought joy to residents on Sunday. Moderate snowfall was recorded in the area with temperatures dropping to as low as minus 2 and minus 1 degrees Celsius. In most parts of the Kashmir Valley, moderate to heavy snowfall continued during the day. Locals said snowfall brings reprieve to persons who were suffering from health problems associated with dry winters and also helped solve problem of water shortage.
बर्फबारी नहीं हुई तो उससे अच्छा नहीं है आज बर्फबारी और इससे हमारी जो बीमारी है सब दूर हो जाएंगे
फॉर मेनी जम्मू एंड कश्मीर इज अ हॉलिडे पैराडाइज स्पेशली ड्यूरिंग द विंटर एज लार्ज नंबर ऑफ टूरिस्ट फ्लॉक टू द रीजन टू विटनेस स्नोफॉल
बर्फबारी का बहुत फ़ायदा है बाद में पानी वानी का भी यहाँ दिक्कत नहीं हो जाता और जैसा हमारे गुलमर्ग है वहाँ पर बर्फबारी का बहुत ही ज़रूरत है क्योंकि हमारे जितने सैलानी है वो यहाँ पे उनको लुत्फ उठाने के लिए अभी बहुत ज़्यादा बर्फ़ की ज़रूरत होता है बाद में वो बहुत इन्जॉय कर सकते हैं
जम्मू एंड कश्मीर इज सराउंडेड बाय माउंटेन्स एंड स्नोफॉल इज क्रूशियल एज द रेजिडेंट्स आर मोस्टली डिपेंडेंट ऑन ग्लेशियर्स एंड स्नो मेल्ट वाटर फॉर ड्रिंकिंग एंड इरीगेशन नीड्स स्नोफॉल ऑल्सो हैज डायरेक्ट इम्पैक्ट ऑन टूरिज्म अ की सेक्टर इन द रीजन्स इकोनॉमी
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude, the top stories once again. Indian Foreign Minister meets SCO Secretary General in New Delhi. Reduction of violence not practical, says Afghan Presidential Palace. A Nepal Parliament session halted for third time amid indecision to choose Speaker. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/SAsianewsline and follow us on Twitter at SAsianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.